when COVID started shutting down restaurants, about 90% of our sales are to restaurants. So we instantly saw the markets close and oysters not being sold.
Wholesale is gone, pretty much. When all the restaurants closed, the wholesale market was depleted, especially in the beginning. Some things came back, but not as plentifully as it used to be. Restaurants that used to take, say, 500 or 600, none this year.
We were able to work with Sea Grant and some other groups to develop a reef restoration project where we're actually going to deploy oysters on our farm that have outgrown the market and allow them to become small reef projects and research projects.
Putting these guys out naturally will help me understand how fast they grow, since I have a good base start here. So it's a great project to be part of.
Well, we're hoping that the results from this experiment will show the importance of reefs, and that even a farm, when it's operating, has an impact that is beneficial to the bay. When we deploy oysters, we instantly see algae start to grow, and then fish and crustaceans move into that area, and then we start to see more and more life and a huge diversity start to occur. This also helps keep the sediments from moving around and creates a structure that protects the shoreline. So it has huge benefits, not to mention that the oysters also now are filtering water, and a large adult oyster can filter anywhere from 25 to 40 gallons of water a day.
I would never think there's value in the fact that, you know, we're filtering over, you know, a trillion gallons of water a day. You know, people should be like really psyched about that, you know?
Having a bunch of farmers involved is really a great thing to join with conservation efforts, especially in the future when we have oysters that are too large for the industry or maybe grow to a funny shape and aren't good for the market. Being able to supplement restoration work will be a benefit to both the bay and the farmers.